The next speaker is the Honourable Bhanga.
Thank you very much, Chairperson.
Order, Honourable Members.
The debate today is youth at the centre of economic opportunities. I want to take it further and say youth at the centre of economic opportunities in advancing the National Youth Development Plan. It is very important as a country. Today I'm not going to speak to you, the ANC. I'm going to speak to the nation. Because today it is a responsibility of the youth of our country to take a bite and a commitment into the National Development Plan. For these reasons, one, as the Congress of the People, we associate ourselves with the new vision of the National Youth Development Agency. For two reasons, because one, we believe investing on education on our young people will take us forward. Investing on skills development of our young people will take us forward. When we grew up, we were told by our parents that we must go to school, go to university and work for us to be able to build a better life for our families. That is gone into our youth because we are not communicating it to our youth. We should make sure that as a country, we are not building a youth that relies on government. The responsibility of government is to lay a foundation for the youth, and the youth must grab those opportunities in building a better country for us. It is a shame that today's youth and today's parents and today's families have to rely to government for them to have a better life. It is the responsibility of the youth of South Africa that we look after our parents, we look after our people, we go to school and learn and build them houses. Mm. This thing of government continuously building houses for people and people burning streets because of lack of taking responsibility as young people, that we have a responsibility to go to school, learn, go to university, and go and work for our families. Therefore, as the Congress of the People, we commit to that vision. Because redirecting your money to education, redirecting your money to skills, takes responsibility and build a youth that understands its responsibilities. Mamunjobe once narrated a story to me in her stay in Ghana, in saying what Kwame Nkrumah built in his youth was to understand that taking responsibility as a youth in building a nation, you'll build a better person, you'll build a better family, you'll build a better nation state. Not all on the ANC, they know the struggle. Not all of them. But this is much important, Chair, because today, the violence we're seeing in our country, it is caused by the very same youth that is supposed to reconstruct a country. The violence we see in Port Elizabeth, where I come from, where African brothers are killed every day, it's something that O.R. Tambo, Kwame Nkrumah will never be proud of. Because the very same Africans, they harbored our parents who are sitting this side and others sitting in this side in their own countries. But we are not a nation that is able to stand up, that we are not going to build a youth in this country that would undermine our struggle to build a better South Africa and a better Africa and a better world. Because Ephraim Mogale, Hector Peterson, they were conscious of what the Freedom Charter says, building friendship for all Africans. What we see today, it's something that as a youth of today, we must not be proud of. All of us, as this collective of parliament, we must be in the forefront of educating our people how important were the struggles of Africa to the struggles of South Africa. Because we're given shelter, we're given food, we're given jobs by the very same people who are killing today. Is it violence that will change our problems? No. Because we didn't want to build a violent South Africa. We wanted to build a better South Africa for generations to come and our children. Therefore, I agree with you, Minister, on some of the things. This youth debate It should be a debate not to celebrate. It should be a debate to commemorate and educate young people of our country about national consciousness, African consciousness, and world consciousness. As long as we don't get to that level, the problems our country is facing in learning, the problems our country is facing when the youth throw human waste in front of a government and the legislative property of this country, and we keep quiet and celebrate. It is something that we must not celebrate. This is not what Govan-Mbeki fought for. This is not what Mandela fought for. Mandela didn't fight that when we take over this country, we have human waste in front of this parliament. The only parliament we wanted to destroy was the Pretoria regime. Pretoria regime is no more. It is our country. It is us as government, the opposition and everybody, that we must take responsibility and give education to our people. We can only achieve as a nation if we educate those who are supposed to take over and inherit the nation. These youth today, which it comes from the ruling party, the opposition benches and everywhere, it's not the kind of the youth that Sphiwe Mthimkhulu was. Sphiwe Mthimkhulu knew that at first he must be in the forefront of the struggles of liberating Omampehle, base South Africa, and giving them what is better. But what are we teaching them? We're teaching them violence. We are teaching them war. You adults who are sitting here, you are responsible.
Honourable Member, your time is expired.
Who are using the youth to do all the wrong things that we are doing in our country. Thank you very much, Chair.
The next speaker is the Honourable Shlengwa.
Honourable House Chairperson, today is not a day for petty politicking or cheap rhetoric. Addressing the Inkatha Youth Brigade on 18 June 1985, IFP President Honorable Buthelezi said, and I quote, "Because there is so much at stake and because there is a vast suffering amongst our people, I believe it is virtually necessary for us to be sure in everything we do. Every failure we make is a failure which costs some people more suffering. Every blunder, we delay final victory and we prolong the suffering of the people. Every misconceived strategy retards progress and increases the difficulties which lie ahead. Our humanity cries out for us to have wise strategies that will work and to embark on ventures which can succeed," close quote. These words are timeless. On the basis of these words, the IFP is committed to nation building and the principles of constructive opposition. Since 1997, the IFP Youth Brigade has called for the creation of a national youth department with a fully fledged ministry to operate in all three spheres of government. This is an issue that we have skated around for far too long. This hide-and-seek game we are playing must come to an end. On 13 November 2004, the IFP Youth Brigade sent a memorandum calling for the establishment of a youth ministry to the presidency. 9 years on, we still await a response. The disjointed manner in which youth matters are handled in this country is at best shameful and inconsistent with the dreams, hopes, and aspirations of young South Africans. This very parliament does not have a committee of any kind, form, or sort to deal with youth matters, except for the ad hoc oversight by the DPME over the NYDA and the, by the way, steering committee on Youth Month. I am glad that the proposal I made to the steering committee on the Youth Parliament for the establishment of a multi-party youth caucus has received support. And this morning, a proposal to that effect was handed over by the steering committee to the presiding officers. The absence of both a youth ministry and a parliamentary committee on youth matters has resulted in the National Youth Development Agency having to squat in the Department of Performance Monitoring and Evaluation. The oversight in this regard on the NYDA is very confusing, disorganized, and peripheral in that the budget allocation for the NYDA comes out of the presidency vote one, but its spending is monitored by another department. Therefore, the money is debated in vote one and overseen somewhere else. The absence of a portfolio committee on the presidency compounds this problem further. In all this chaos, honorable members, it is the youth of South Africa that is left wanting. Youth development deserves the same treatment as women development, as it is prioritized through the Department of Women, Children and People with Disabilities and the Portfolio Committee and the Multi-Party Women's Caucus. The sacrifices of our past should spur us into action to improve the lives of all South Africans, particularly the youth, who are hit hardest by each and every failure. We owe it to the memory of the youth of 1976, the youth of 2013, and the youth of tomorrow to establish the necessary institutions that will ensure that we alleviate their plight and guarantee that they secure their sustainable livelihoods. We can no longer pay lip service to youth development. The rhetoric is stale. The time for implementation is now. In conclusion, let me say, the failure of government to fast-track job creation, particularly amongst the youth, is something that the ruling party is going to regret in the elections next year. Sort it out very, very quickly. I thank you.